towards the front of the room. Let's just take a few deep breaths to allow ourselves to arrive right here, right now. Inhale the arms up. And exhale the arms back down. Again, inhale the arms up. Exhale the arms down. One more, inhale the arms up. Exhale the arms down. And just roll the shoulders up, back, and down. Let your right hand slide down your right side body till it doesn't go any further. And bring your left arm over your left ear. Inhaling your right arm up, just catch your left wrist and feel that side body stretch. Use an inhale to come back up. Exhale the arms down by your sides. Let the left arm slide down the left side body until it doesn't go any further. Bring the right arm over the right ear. Inhale the left arm up, catch the wrist, and just feel that side body stretch. Beautiful. Use an inhale to come back up. Exhale the arms down by your sides. Interlace your fingers behind you. Push your pelvis forward. Lift your heart, leaning back to the degree that feels comfortable to you. And then slowly hinge forward. I step my feet a little wider. Soften the knees. And just let the interlaced fingers continue to fall forward. As you hang your head, it might feel nice to nod the head yes and no. We'll float the hands to the floor and step the left foot back for low lunge. And as we sink the hips and lift the gaze, keep the left or the right knee right over the heel and sweep the right arm up for simple twist. And then just enjoy whatever variation with that right arm feels good. So if you wanted to add movement, you could. Half binding. And then straddle the right foot with both hands. Tap the left knee down. Shift the hips back, flexing all five toes. And just ripple the breath. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale. Just let a breath wash over you here. Come back to a runner's stretch, extending the back leg. Rooting the hands down. Kick the right leg up and back, and then open the hip for your twister. Beautiful. You can find movement if it serves you. Stillness. Stir it around in ways that feel good. Beautiful. Extend the right leg gaze forward. Bring the right foot all the way through. Low lunge. Now, step the left foot to meet the right, and we're back to our forward fold. Good. Roll up one vertebrae at a time, and roll the shoulders back and down. Inhale the arms up overhead, and swan dive forward on your exhale. Inhale to lengthen, but just forward fold on your exhale. We're just in warm-up mode. Step your right foot back, low lunge. And as you sink your hips, check that knee to heel alignment. Beautiful. Sweeping your left arm up for simple twist. Once again, any arm variation that feels good as you explore your space and deepen your breath. Exactly, make it feel good. Straddle the left foot with both hands. Tap the right knee down. Shift the hips back, flexing all five toes. Let's ripple the breath. Inhale. Exhale. Again, inhale. And exhale. One more. Inhale. Exhale. And just let a breath wash over you. Coming back through runner's stretch. Extend the back legs. Perfect. Root the hands down and then kick the left leg up and back, opening the hip for your twister pose. Enjoy movement if it serves you. Stillness if that feels better. Extend the left leg, open through. Step the left foot forward, low lunge, pause. Step the right foot to meet the left and forward fold. Reverse swan dive, back up. Nice. Hands to heart center. Inhale the arms up. Swan dive forward on your exhale, nice and slow. Inhale, hands to shins. Forward fold, just pause. Still in warm up mode. Step back to high plank. As we push the heels back and the heart forward, strong planks. Drop the knees. Three modified chaturangas where you go down. Inhale, that's one. Beautiful. Exhale, down. Inhale. One more. Exhale, down. Inhale. Curl the toes under, downward facing dog. Yeah, nice. Our first downward facing dog, just sort of pedal it out. Yeah, make it feel good. You might be in a miracle. Can lift down dog. Kick your right leg up and back. Open your hip. You've got your twister. We've been here before. Extend the right leg open three. As we gaze forward, right knee to right elbow, give it a strong tap, yes. Inhale and kick it back. Right knee to left elbow, tricep, strong tap, beautiful. Inhale, kick it back. Bring your right foot all the way through, low to high lunge. Use a smooth inhale to rise, take your time, and then just settle in here, feel the up and the down. Keeping a low center of gravity, catch your left wrist with your right hand and just lean to the right. It's a little wobbly. Feel that side body stretch for three. Two. As we come back up to our high lunge, bring your hands to heart center. Warrior two. Feel your left hip roll back. Warrior two. Beautiful. Three pendulums. Inhale, arc it back. Exhale, extended side angle. Again, inhale, big arcing motion back. Exhale, extended side angle. Two. One more. Inhale, big arcing motion back. Exhale, extended side angle. As you hold here, you might find yourself expanding your arm variation if you want to. And just breathe for three. Breathe for two. So nice. Straddle the right foot with both hands. Step back to high plank. Exhale, low plank. And then come all the way onto your belly. Tiptoe your hands to the diagonal and prop your heart up. Yeah. Good. Gaze to the right. Dip your left shoulder. Back through center. And gaze to the left. Beautiful. Come back through center. Come all the way back down onto your belly. And press into child's pose. This is the first child's pose we've been in for this class. And just take a few nice deep breaths into your back body, noticing any tightness or tension. Let's make our way onto all fours with an inhale. Downward facing dog on an exhale. Kicking the left leg up and back, we open the hip, we've been here before. Extending the left leg, open through. Gaze forward. Left knee to left elbow, tricep, give it a strong tap. Inhale, kick it back. Left knee to right elbow, tricep, strong tap. Inhale, kick it back. Left foot through. Low to high lunge. Take your time. Take your time. Rise your inhale. Settle on your exhale. Pause. Beautiful. Catching your right wrist with your left hand. It's a subtle lean to the left. Yeah, good. Breathe three. Two. Inhale back to your upright. Bring your hands to heart center. Warrior two. Feel the right hip and shoulder roll back. Beautiful. Three pendulums. Inhale, arch it back. Exhale, extended side angle. Again, inhale, big arching motion back. Exhale, extended side angle. One more. Inhale, arch it back. Exhale, extended side angle as you hold and breathe. Again, any arm variations that just feel good. Breathe in. Breathe two. Straddle the left foot with both hands. Step back to high plank. First, full vinyasa. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, the up dog. You can linger here if it feels good, a hybrid if it feels better. We meet in downward facing dog. You get there when you get there. Yeah. Extend your knees and gaze forward. It's always a choice whether you jump or step the feet in. Nice. Flat back. Inhale. Forward fold. Exhale. Reverse swan dive. Back up on your inhale. Hands to heart center. Exhale. Full flow. Inhale the arms up. Swan dive forward on your exhale. Flat back to prepare. Step or spring through your favorite vinyasa. You could add multiple push-ups if you felt like it. Linger in your up dog. Choices. Find your way back to down dog when it makes sense to you. Last warm-up set. Spin your left heel into the earth. Bring your right foot through. Warrior one. Use your strong inhale to rise. Three wrapping rounds where we exhale and hug the hamstrings. Beautiful. Inhale, come back up. That's one. Exhale, wrap and round. Yeah. Inhale, that's two. One more. Exhale, wrap and round. Inhale, that's three. Got your exercise on that. Come into your cactus arms. Interlace the fingers behind you. Squeeze the legs. Lift the heart. Lean back. And then round forward on your exhale. Yeah. Keep pushing into the outer edge of your left foot. Breathing into your back body for three. Breathing for two. Use a strong inhale to come back up to warrior one. Bring your left arm under your right eagle arms. Bring your left leg over your right and we're an upright eagle. We sit and squeeze. Crouching eagle. as we hinge forward, yeah. Just hover here, squeezing. We're gonna keep the eagle arms, but add a warrior three left leg. So as you unhook it and kick it back, sort of making a capital and a T shape with your body. Breathe, you can soften your right knee, you might wobble. In three, we'll drop back to warrior one, two. Warrior one, sweep the arms up, feel the release. Glide open to warrior two. Inhale, reverse your warrior. And straighten your right leg, yeah. Any arm variations as you feel those long side bodies, beautiful. Breathe. Come back to your upright spine, arms parallel to the mat. Trikonasana, cut the hips as you reach and bring your arms to 12 and 6. Any arm variation that feels good, yeah. So whether you half bind, whether you float your right arm up, or keep your right hand rooted for a block, breathe. Yeah, beautiful. Use a strong inhale to come back up, warrior two, and pause, yeah. Windmill to your down dog, split. Kick your right leg up and back, but this time keep your hips square. Glide forward to three-legged plank, and gently tap your left knee. Now kick up, look up, three sunbirds, where we dip down on the exhale. Inhale, that's one. Perfect. Do it again. Exhale, dip down. Inhale, two. One more. Exhale, dip down. Inhale, three. Now bring your right knee to your belly button and just curl into a little ball. Push the floor down. Kick the right leg straight back. Curl the left toe under. Down dog split. Perfect. Step your right foot through. Low to high lunge. Use a smooth inhale to rise. Now your right leg is all set up for Utkatasana. It's a very slow transition. Just step the left foot next to the right. Sit the hips back and down. And here we are in Utkatasana. You just sort of explore. The down, the up. Yeah, beautiful. Breathe three. Breathe two. Forward fold, Uttanasana. Flat back, prepare. Favorite flow to down dog. Last side of our warm up. Spin your right heel into the earth, left foot through, warrior one. Use your inhale to rise, your exhale to arise. Beautiful. Three wrapping rounds. Exhale. Three. Inhale, that's one. Exhale, wrap and round. Inhale, that's two. One more. Exhale, wrap and round. Inhale, that's three. As you pause, relax your shoulders. Come into your cactus arms. Keep your heart lifted. Interlace your fingers behind you. Squeeze your blades. Lift your heart some more. Lean back. And round forward on your exhale. And then just linger here. Keep pushing into the outer blade of the right foot. Feel the space you're creating in your back body. Use your inhale to rise back up to warrior one. Bring your right arm under your left, eagle arms. Bring your right leg over your left, and we're in upright eagle. And as we sit back and down, beautiful, we hinge forward for crouching eagle. Now you can create some space in the back body by pulling the elbows forward. We're squeezing, we're breathing, you might wobble. Keep the eagle arm, warrior three, right leg as you kick back. Pull your heart forward. Rough count of three will bring us back to warrior one. Two. As we drop back to warrior one, sweep the arms up. Glide open to warrior two. Perfect. Reverse your warrior and tilt back. And then straighten your left leg. And just enjoy that reverse triangle on your terms. Come back to your upright spine. Trikonasana. As you reach and bring the arms to 12 and 6. Whether you use leverage with your left hand on a block or your shins or the floor, what does the right arm want to do? Does it want to reach or bind? And if you're not sure, just explore and breathe and feel and make it yours. Exactly. So nice. Three. Two. Slow motion, we come back up to warrior two, gazing over the left hand. Windmill to your down dog, split. Kick your left leg up and back, the hips are square. We glide forward to three-legged plank and drop the right knee. Kick up, look up, three sunbirds. Exhale, dip down, nice. Inhale, one. Exhale, dip down. Inhale, two. Exhale, dip down. Inhale, three, pause. Bring your knee to your nose and just curl into a little ball. Push the floor down and breathe into the back body. Curling the right toe under. Kick the left leg up and back when in down dog split. Perfect. Pause. Bring your left foot through, low to high lunge. Nice slow inhale to rise. Regroup here. Shoulders down, heart high. Again. Left leg is all set up for Utkatasana. Slow is the way to go. Stepping the right foot to meet the left. We're in our awkward chair pose. If you want to bring your arms to cactus, if that feels better, any variation, just explore. Don't let the knees sort of go over the big toes. Keep sitting back and down. That's why it's called awkward. Yeah, perfect. All right, let's slow. Exhale, Uttanasana. Flat back, prepare. Step or string, favor vinyasa. Inhaling and exhaling. Meeting downward facing dog. Nice, nice. All right, that was the warm up. Let's bend the knees, gaze forward. Step or float the feet in. Flat back, inhale. Forward fold, exhale. Reverse swan dive, back up, inhale. Hands to heart center. Water whenever you need it, okay? You okay? All right. Inhale the arms up. This one is not full flow. Dive forward on your exhale. Inhale hands to shins, but just forward fold on your exhale and pause. Step your left foot back, low to high lunge. Use a smooth inhale to rise. As we settle into this high lunge, your left arm comes forward, your right arm comes back. Open arms, good. Three scissor repeaters where we inhale, straighten, arms come up, good. Exhale, beautiful, nice and slow. Inhale. Exhale. Good. One more. Inhale. And exhale. As you pause here, swim to warrior two. Your right arm swims forward. Your left arm rolls back. Good. Long side bodies. We take Bikram lunging triangle. Different than extended side angle. And that we try to stay a little more lifted in the right rib cage. We're not trying to touch the floor, we're trying to reach through the ceiling. Beautiful. Breathe three. Breathe two. Stay with me. Straddle your right foot with both hands. Spin onto the ball of the left foot. Step back to high plank, toes and heels together. And lift your right arm for side plank. Now whether you lift the leg, drop a knee, reach an arm, so many different variations. In three, we flow. Breathe two. Take your favorite vinyasa. Exhaling and inhaling. Right into the second side. Step your left foot forward, low to high lunge. Use a smooth inhale to rise. Again, grounding down to reach up. Feel all the directionals. As the right arm comes forward and the left arm comes back, nice and slow. Inhale, straighten, but don't lock the knee. Exhale, these are our repeaters. Perfect, do it again. Inhale. Yeah, just shy of locking the knee. Exhale. Perfect. Do it again. Inhale. And exhale. Pause, pause. Swing the arms to warrior two. Feel that right shoulder and hip roll back. Beautiful. Keep long side bodies for Bikram's lunging triangle, where we reach up with the same intensity that we reach down. And you squeeze your shoulder blades onto your back body. And you breathe. Four, three. Breathe. Two. Straddle the left foot with both hands. Step back to high plank, toes and heels together. Lift your left arm, side plank. Again, any variation that feels better for your wrist, elbow, shoulder. Breathe through. Breathe through. Yes. Favorite flow to down dog. Exhale and inhale. As you glide through the vinyasa, releasing downward facing dog. Yeah, good. I'm glad you're heating up a little bit. Tiptoe the hands back to the feet. Once we come into this forward fold, heel toe your feet about inner hips distance apart. Take your peace fingers around your big toes and let's add three nice deep breaths. Inhale. Big exhale, hara. Again, inhale. One more, inhale. We'll release the yoga cobra. Soften the knees and just roll up one vertebrae at a time, rolling the shoulders back and down. We're going to take a walk up our mat, tree to dancer's pose, nice and slow. Step the left foot forward, bring the right knee up to hip height. I'm just going to add a little something here. Before we come into tree, just extend your right leg out in front of you. It doesn't matter how high, but engage the core. Circle the ankle one way. Circle the ankle the opposite way. Come back through flexion. Right foot to the inner left leg for tree pose. Bringing the hands to heart center. Allow the arms to stretch up. Allow the arms to reach out. If you'd like to add some movement, go for it. Any kind of arm variation. And breathe. One more add-on. Swing your right arm out to the side. Kick your right foot behind you. Tap it with your right hand. Spin the left palm towards the front of the room. And begin to kick and reach. Yes. Again. Maybe fall out, come back in. Five, four, three, two. Use a smooth inhale, nice, to come back up. Step your right foot forward, we're taking another walk. Bring your left knee up to hip height. And then extend the left leg out in front of you. Circle the ankle one way. Circle the ankle the opposite way. Come back through flexion. And then bending the knee, come into tree pose. The sole of the foot, anywhere but on the knee joint. High or lower, the hands come to heart center. As the arms stretch up, the shoulders melt down. Any little variations you want to add here, you breathe. Good times, guys. Good times. Swing your left arm out to the side. Catch the inside of your left foot, bringing the knees together to start. And then kicking back and reaching forward for your dancer's pose. Yeah. It's dynamic. Five, four, three, two. Left foot meets the right, your hands are at heart center. Anytime you want to take a sip of water or towel your brow, we're at the top of the mat. Come into Utkatasana. In this awkward chair pose, bring your hands to heart center. Plug into all 10 toes and lift your heels, squeezing your inner ankles. Yes, breathe, breathe. Breathe, two. The heels come down and the arms reach up. Yeah, good. Bring your hands back to heart center and take your twist to the right. As you anchor and rotate, whether your arms extend or stay in prayer, whether you use a block, yeah. We're going to gaze down at the big toes and step the left foot back, low lunge, twist. So as you roll your chest open to the right, you have time to maybe add any arm variation that feels good. Binding, half binding. Breathing for three. Breathing for two. Slow motion, come back up to high lunge. The arms up, the shoulders down, yeah. Glide open to warrior two. Perfect, perfect. Inhale the arms up and straighten the right leg. Pivot the right toe in. Bring your hands to your hips. Push your pelvis forward, lift your heart, lean back. And back bend forward on your exhale. Nice and slow. This first one, we won't include the inversion. The second side, we will. Bending your right knee for Svendasana. Let your hands stay down or come to heart center. It's a long spine. Whether you flex your foot, your hips might go way deeper than mine. Do the best you can. Exactly. And then slowly go over to the other side. So as you bend your left knee, just sort of see how that feels on your hamstring, your inner thigh, long spine. And then we set ourselves free. So going back and forth, side to side, maybe swing your arms. There's not one prescribed pace, so you sort of find a rhythm. If it helps to close your eyes and just sort of feel yourself gliding side to side. At some point, we'll meet in a forward fold, straddle. Yeah. We regroup here. Good. Perfect. Perfect. Bring your hands to your hips and use a strong inhale to come on up. Bring your hands to your sacral spine, tuck your tail under, lift your heart, lean back, and come back to your upright spine. Yeah. Extend your arms, pivot your right toes to the front of the room. So let me tell you what's happening. First, it's Ardha Chandrasana, five breaths, revolved Ardha Chandrasana, five breaths, and we meet in standing stretch. So let's first knock the toes over on its side for half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. As you explore, slow, steady five breaths, any variations that are interesting to you, keeping it simple, you'll get everything you need. Breathe three. Breathe two. Now lower your left hand down and square off your hips. Just take a moment and then sweep your right arm up and you're in revolve. Half moon. The chest, yes, opens up. And once again, you might explore different variations. Beautiful. Breathe. Nice. Before you get too tired, drop both hands down and we're in standing split. Now standing split, if you have a handstand practice, you might choose to play with a few little pop-ups to handstand. You can come with me through knee bend curtsies as you sort of navigate what works for you. Find the fun. Find the fun. Yeah. And eventually, both feet land in front of the mat. You tuck the chin into the throat and you roll up one vertebra at a time, rolling the shoulders back and down. Notice, no connecting vinyasa. We go right into Utkatasana, how we start in the first side. Bringing the hands to heart center, take your twist to the left. As we anchor and rotate, good. Gazing down with the big toes, slowly step the right foot back and win our lunge twist. And as we sink the hips, you can explore arm variations. It might be on one side something's available and on the other side not so much. So sort of listen to those little things your body tells you. Breathe in. Breathe two. Slow motion, make your way up to high lunge and pause. As we pause in high lunge, a face will open up to warrior two. Let's open up to warrior two. Yeah, exactly. From this warrior two, inhale the arms up and straighten the left leg. Pivot the left toe in. Bring the hands to the hips. Push the pelvis forward. Lift the heart. Lean back. And back bend forward on your exhale. So here you could add an inversion. I am not going to. You can come with me, walking your hands forward, allowing yourself to twist. As you explore your inversion, it might be that you have a mom or a wall to use as a little support, so feel free. And as you enjoy whatever upside down variation you take, just know that at some point you're going to be in a forward fold style. You'll get there when you get there. Enjoy. Once we're in forward fold straddle, slowly bring your hands to hips. Go slow on the inhale because we've been upside down for a little bit. So slow to come up so we don't drain the brain too fast. Yeah. Bring your hands to your sacral spine. Enjoy a little back bend to release. Perfect. Come back to your upright spine. Extend your arms. Just pivot your left toe. We're in warrior two. So. You remember, we knock this pose over on its side for half moon. Five slow, deep breaths. You stay here for as long as your five breaths lend themselves to you, any variation. remember, you don't have to come along with my voice. I'm just trying to estimate an even 5 count. At some point, both hands drop down and we square off the hips. Revolve half moon, where the hips stay square, the chest open, and then once again, you start sort of witnessing your breath and adding variations. There's no doubt that your left leg is starting to get a little tired here, so use that breath. Meeting me in standing splits when you're ready, and once again, taking the knee bend curtsies with me or playing with the little upside down time. Eventually, both feet down, and we roll up one vertebra at a time, rolling the shoulders back and down. What's that mean? All right, full flow. Inhale the arms up, and swan dive forward. Exhale. Flat back, prepare. Step or spring for your favorite vinyasa. Left heel into the earth, bring your right foot through, warrior one, use your inhale to rise. As we pause in this warrior one, bring your hands to heart center. Bring your left ankle to your right knee quad, figure four pose. Now we're here long enough that if you wanted to add an arm balance, you could, or a twist. As you explore your different variations, You have time. Just make it feel good. Just enjoy. At some point, we're gonna meet back in Warrior One. Take your time. Once we meet in Warrior One, take your time. We regroup, perfect. Straighten the right leg, yay. Take opposite elbows or yoga prayer behind you. Bump your hips forward, lean back with your heart. And back bend forward. Steer your torso over your right knee shin and breathe. Like a rolling pin is going over your spine. Use a strong inhale to come back up, warrior one. Straighten the right leg. Bring the right hand to the hip. Revolve triangle, left hand in or outside the right foot, floor block. As the right arm stretches up, the left hand presses down. The hips draw back, the heart folds forward. And then just focus on that slow rhythmic breath. Yeah. Breathe in through. Two. Nice and slow. Tiptoe the hand around to the left. As you pivot your right toe and we're in our forward fold again, pause. Pivot both heels, one rotation in. Bend the knees. Sit the hips back. Yes. Climb the hands to the knees. We're in a squat. From squat pose, bring your arms to cactus, and then feel your pelvis pressing forward, turning this more into goddess. You might pivot your feet a little bit wider. Yeah, exactly. Once you get to goddess pose, interlace your fingers overhead. Spin your palms up, drop your feet down. Lift your right heel up. Breathe, three, two, yeah. Right heel down, left heel up, plug into the big toe now. Breathe in for three. Two. Left heel down, Both heels up. 5, 4, 3, 2. Nice. Both heels down. Slowly straighten the legs again. Bring the hands to the hip. Pivot your left heel to the back of the room, right toe to the front of the room, and sit in Warrior 2. From this Warrior 2, we come into extended side angle. This extended side angle is slowly going to bring us to a balanced position. You could choose Bird of Paradise, Tree, or Uttita. If you're coming with me, left hand to right hip, a half bind. Full bind if you're playing with Bird of Paradise. As you step the left foot to meet the right, take your time. You've got to pick up that right foot. Whatever variation, if you find yourself wanting to change or what you planned, it's fine. So Tree or Bird of Paradise. In 3, we'll meet with both feet down, that's all. 3, 2. As you slowly place the right foot down on your terms, we meet with our hands at heart center. We heel toe the feet to Malasana and regroup here. From this Malasana, right arm down, left arm up. Whether you bind around your shin or your hamstring, or don't bind at all, twist and breathe. Beautiful. As we come back through heart center, left arm down, right arm up, big opening. And once again, whether you bind or half bind, breathe, 3, yeah, 2. As we come back to heart center, we're not taking crow on this first one, the second one we can. As you put your hands down, step back to high plank. Come down onto your elbows and forearms, and we're in forearm plank. Now, 5 dolphin pikes. That means you pike your hips up on the exhale. Inhale, low dolphin. Yeah, do it again. Exhale, pike the hips up. Inhale, low dolphin. 3 more. Exhale, pike the hips up. Inhale, low dolphin. 2 more. Exhale, pike the hips up. Inhale, low dolphin. Last one. Exhale, pike the hips up. Come back to low dolphin. Second set, we're going to tiptoe the feet towards the elbows and come into a tight and pike high dolphin. And these are called dolphin dips. So we pull the chin beyond the knuckles forward and dip, and then push back. That's 1. Inhale. And exhale, 2. You guys know this song. Inhale. Exhale. 2 more. Inhale. Exhale, last one. Inhale. Exhale. From high dolphin, just throw your feet back. We're in low dolphin. And we hold. And we breathe. 5, 4, 3, 2. You lower the hips down, chest and chin on the mat, arms out to the side, legs together like one leg. Inhale, peel your chin, chest, arms and legs off the mat, and float. Breathe, 3. Breathe, 2. And lower down, press back to child's pose. To the right. And use your hands to leverage your hips back and enjoy a big breath into the back and side. And And then tiptoe the hands back through center and over to the left. Again, really focus on slow, deep breath in and out. Come back to the center. Tiptoe your hands back in. And come onto our knees and shin, knees about inner hips distance apart. Bringing our hands to our sacral spine and back bending. This is a conservative camel. If you know you have a pretty bendy spine and you want to bring your hands to your heels to come, if you feel like it's at all tricky on your back, I should keep your hands at your sacral spine and enjoy the back bend that's a little more supported. Breathe through. Two. Slowly, come on up. Again, it's a big brain drain, so it easy does it. Hands down. Downward facing dog. This is our last side. Our last side. Spin the right heel into the earth. Bring the left foot through. Warrior one. Use your inhale to rise. We pause. From this warrior one, bring your hands to heart center and bring your right ankle to your left knee quad for figure four pose. And as you explore figure four pose, just like the other side, whether your fingertips touch down or you take a twist, whether you add an arm balance, breathe into your back body. If you need more time, just take it. You'll just regroup and meet back in Warrior One when you're ready. Making our way back to Warrior One. Yeah, perfect, perfect. All right. From this Warrior One, straighten your left leg. Bring your left hand to your hip. Revolve triangle, right hand. In or outside of the left foot floor, block or shin. As you press down to reach up, pull the heart forward. Push the hips back. Breathe. Yeah. Perfect. Slow motion. Tiptoe your hands around to the right. As you pivot your left toe and you come into this forward fold, you pivot the heels one rotation in, sit the hips back and down, plant, climb the hands onto the knees, we're in this squat. Let's dip the left shoulder, knees to the right, and come back to the center. Gaze to the left and dip the right shoulder. Come back for the center. Same transition. We climb the arms up to cactus and then adjust the pelvis so we come into our goddess and sit a little deeper. This time, bring your right arm under your left eagle arm. On your exhale, we're going to round forward. Yeah. On your inhale, you're going to come back up. Beautiful. Do it again. Exhale. Round down. Inhale, come back up. Exhale, round down. Inhale, come back up. As we come into Cactus Goddess, if you find your legs cramping up, you can always inhale, straighten them and re-bend them. Other side, left arm under right, eagle arm. Exhale, round forward, yeah. Inhale, come back up. Do it again. Exhale. Round forward. Inhale. Come back up. One more. Exhale. Round forward. Nice. Inhale. Come back up. Pause. Come back to your cactus arms. Let's get the relief together. Slowly straighten the legs. Yes. Extend the arms. Pivot your right heel to the back of the room, left toe to the front of the room, warrior two. Yeah. All right. As we get into our extended side angle here, think slow motion. half bind, full bind. We're bringing this to a balance. As slow as possible. Step your right foot to meet your left. Pick up your left foot when you're ready. Bird of paradise, or tree, or any variation of balance. Again, it's a dynamic journey. Just witness it without judgment. In three, both feet are gonna touch down. Two, go slow. The exit's part of your journey. Yeah, nice. We regroup with our hands at heart center, and we heel toe to our malasana. As you sink into your malasana, if you're not interested in bakasana crow, you can take those forearm planks again. Otherwise, putting your hands down and playing with your forearm, or not your forearm, but your crow pose. Some people come into headstand and back to crow. Some people jump back. Yeah. As you navigate your journey, just know that before you get too tired, it's an optional flow, and we meet in child's pose. Exhaling and inhaling, not optional. Fold the arms by your sides and just give those shoulders a little rest here. Breathing into the back body. As you slowly curl up, come onto your knees, shins. If you have a neighbor, you might stagger with him, her, or fluffball. As your right leg extends out to the side, let your right hand slide down your right leg and reach your left arm over your left ear. Just let it feel good. As we inhale and come up, the left hand under the left shoulder, the right arm up. You might use a block under your left hand. Some people lift their right leg, I do not. As you sort of navigate your journey, just feel that nice long right side body stretch. Now be very mindful when you come up. First of all, your right foot has to be down. Use a strong inhale to come back up, yeah. And then just switch the leg. Bring the right knee back in, extend the left leg out to the side. Let the left hand slide down the left leg, reaching to the left, breathing into the side bodies. Inhale, come back up. Again, right hand under your shoulder, maybe a block. As your left arm comes up, any variation that just feels stable to you, whether you lift a leg, grab a foot, I don't know. But just feel and breathe. Two, be very careful as you use your inhale to come back up. Good. Both knees come back to place. We come onto our hands and knees. Extend your right arm forward and your left leg back. Elbow to knee, curl into a little ball. Good. Inhale, come back for extension. Do it again. Elbow to knee, curl into a ball. Inhale, one more. Exhale, curl into a little ball. Come back for extension. Bend your left knee, reach your right arm back. It's not a guarantee that you're going to find your foot back there, but if you do, enjoy. Some people come onto their left elbow forearm. I do not. Yeah. Breathe. Three. Two. If you are on your elbow forearm, very slow motion to come back up. And then come back through extension. Right arm, left leg. Sorry about that. And release. Left arm forward, right leg back. Yeah. Doing it again on the other side. Elbow to knee, we curl into a ball. Come back through extension. Two more. Elbow to knee, we curl into a ball. Come back for extension. One more. Elbow to knee. We curl into a little ball. Come back for extension as we pause here. Bend your right knee. Reach your left arm back. Finding that foot back there. Again, if it's available and you want to go onto your right elbow, forearm. Yeah, just easy does it on those transitions. You breathe through. Two, nice and slow, okay? You come back off. Come back for extension. Left arm, right leg. Reach, 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 reach. Perfect. And release. We're still on all fours. Inhale the right arm up and open the chest. And then thread the right arm under the left armpit. Anything you want to do with your left hand to add a nice spinal twist. Yeah. Exactly. And then we unthread the needle. Come back onto all fours. Inhale the left arm up. And thread the left arm under. Enjoy that twist on your turn. As you slowly unthread, tiptoe your hands back, sit on your heels, pause, unfold your legs from under you. Extend your right leg to the diagonal. Bring the sole of the left foot to the inner right leg. Inhale the arms up overhead. Pivot and hinge over the right leg. Beautiful. Breathe into that body. Use a strong inhale to come back up. Bring your left hand under your left shoulder. Beautiful pose. And just pop yourself up. Yeah, just make it feel good. Find a surrender. And release. Other side. Left leg to the diagonal. Right shoulder of the foot to the inner leg. Inhale the arms up overhead, pivot and hinge over your left leg. Yeah. Breathe into your back body, keep your shoulders level. Inhale, come back up. Bring your right hand under your right shoulder and lift up. Creating symmetry, doing the same thing on each side, experiencing each moment as it comes. And lower back down. Now extend both legs out in front of you. Feet flexed. Inhale the arms up. I'm pointing my toes so my mom doesn't see my bandages. And we hinge forward on the exhale. As you fold over those legs, invite the breath, lower, deeper. Use your inhale to rise. Bring your arms down, hands under shoulders. Reverse tabletop if your back bothers you. Incline plane and lift the hips. If this bothers your back, you bend your knees and take reverse tabletop. Breathe here for three. Enjoy the opening that feels right on your body for two. And we lower the hips. Come down one elbow at a time. And one shoulder at a time. Place your feet on the floor with your knees bent. And come into your bridge pose. Just first back bend, just snuggle your shoulders under, feel your knees drawing gently away from your hips, your tail tucked under. Your chest sort of gently pressing up towards your chin, but don't wedge your chin into your chest. As we lower the hips down, just let the knees knock together. Next, back bend. You could add full wheel here. So you could put a block under your sacral spine for supported bridge, or you could take regular bridge. So as you play here, enjoy. Do all the things that make you happy. And just knowing that at some point, while I go get blocked, you meet me in Supta Baddha Konasana. So making your way slowly, gently to your Supta Baddha Konasana. That means soles of the feet together, knees fall out to the side, you're on your back. Take your time, enjoy. If you don't have a block handy, doesn't matter. You could just simply use a box from all your Amazon things that you've got. So you're going to take the block between your inner knees. I, of course, have a block. We're on our back. And you're going to extend your legs up. And then you're going to transfer your block box to your inner ankle. Now, it's just going to be a transfer of energy. You're going to reach up, transfer the block into your hands, lower your legs to a diagonal, arms overhead, and then just continue on your journey, just sort of passing the block or box or whatever you were passing. And how many you do and how fast you do them is totally up to you. But I'd like you to get into a little rhythm here, where you just feel how your inhale allows you to rise, your exhale allows you to descend. And just notice how you probably can maintain that rhythm for quite a while. And the temptation is to count, but don't. What I want you to use as your gauge is when your abdominal muscles feel some fatigue, and when they do feel enough fatigue that feels satisfying, stop. And just place the block to the side, meeting on your backs with your knees bent. From here, pull your right knee to your right shoulder and pull your left knee to your left shoulder. So in wide knee child's pose. And then we kick the heels up and come into happy baby. As we rock from side to side to side, exactly. It might feel really nice to extend one leg at a time or both legs. I love that. At the same time to get a nice stretch up and down the backs of the legs. And then as we guide the legs back up over the hips, it's our final inversion. So I like to come into shoulder stand, but you might have a headstand practice or whatever upside down position you just feel like maintaining for a while. We're very close to the end of this class. Remember, you can play with shoulder stand, you might like plow, you might like to just allow your legs. eventually we do come out of that inversion. Our feet are on the floor, our knees are bent. Your arms comfortably out to the side, your elbows can be bent. Heel toe each foot so you can feel the edge of the mat under the sole of your foot feet. Let both knees fall to the right as you gaze to the left. You can add that ankle to outer knee to get a little more sensation and stretch in your outer left hip. Center. Let both knees fall to the left as you gaze to the right. Your left heel can climb onto your right knee. And as you release, and we come into our final resting pose, whatever is comfy for you. Allow yourself to drift. Feeling very grateful to my two beautiful daughters who encouraged me to make this happen. Thank you. You want to continue your Shavasana, just turn this off and continue your rest, your meditation. You're ready to come back and slowly make our way onto our sides in fetal pose. And then slowly we press ourselves up to a comfortable seated position, resting the hands on the knees of the dog. We bring our hands to heart center. Tough times these days. Easy does it. Namaste.